Hello everyone, this is exercise number 4 on word processors, and in this exercise we are going to copy this text about Leonardo da Vinci, and we will apply the format, the font Verdana on a size of 14 to everything. So you will have this attached to your task. So I'm selecting everything, control copy, and I'm going to word processor and I'm pasting it. There you go. Now I am selecting everything and Verdana. There you go. Size 14. This is how we start. Okay, let's see what's next. Center the title, underlined. Size 20 in an orange color. So let's go. This is the title. We center it. Size 20 and orange color. That's it. So the next paragraph is centered to size 8. Make sure that the links are active in blue color. So this is the paragraph and we want it centered, and the size is 8, really small, and make sure that the links are active. These links are not active right now, so you put the cursor at the end of the line and then press enter, and that should do it. Press enter again here, and now I erase this line. That's it. Okay, so if I click here, it will take me to the website. That's nice. Okay, what's next? Justify all the other paragraphs in the text and apply a double line spacing. Okay, I will select everything else, and this is justified text. You see all the lines end at the same point. This is not justified, this is justified. That's the difference. It looks much better that way. And the line spacing is the space in between the lines. So everything is selected and they want a double. Double is here. You see the difference? This is simple and this is double. That's right. So next thing to do, or italic format to Mona Lisa and the Last Supper. Mona Lisa, because these are paintings by Leonardo, italic and the Last Supper. That's right. All right, so that was quite quick. Now we have to search for a free image of Mona Lisa, and we have to place it at the right side of the first paragraph. Adjust the size of the image so it looks good. Make sure that it's well aligned with the margins of the text. I'll show you how to do this. We want a picture of the Mona Lisa at this side of this paragraph, so let's go. Mona Lisa, images, and we want it free, no copyright, so we click here. I also don't want images that are too big, so I click here on size. I guess this should be okay. Right click, and I'll copy the image back to the Word document. I'm gonna paste it here. Control V. This is really big, so I'm adjusting the size. So as I told you before, to put images within the text, you have to click here and choose a square or cuadrado. You can also right click in the image. Here is the same. And now you can move it all around the text. And we want it there. You see, it is aligned with the margins. I don't want something like that. That is terrible. Please don't do that. There. Okay, that looks quite good. That's nice. What else? Number four here. Create a text box with Mona Lisa by Leonardo da Vinci, Arial size 8 and italic. And we have to place it right below the image and group it with the image. Okay, this is easy to do. We have to insert a text box like this one. And the text we want here is Mona Lisa by Leonardo da Vinci. And this should go over here. It is Arial size 8 and italic. That's it. We don't want this line. So I select the text box and the outline. We don't want a line there. You see, with a line, no line. And I'm going to place it right below there. I think it goes well. That looks good. And now I press Control. So I select the text box and the image. Both are selected now. And now I go to Group and Group. So now they are a block. They are a group. And I can move them around. Place them wherever I want to. There you go. So what's next? Number five, do the same like in steps 3 and 4 with a picture of the self-portrait of Leonardo. Place it at the left side of the last paragraph. Okay, and this is what they want in the text box. Okay, let's do that. That's right. So let's see what's next. Then we have to apply a header to the document. So we have to double click in the upper part of any page in the document. Left side of the header, we have to write ES Infanta Elena, and to the right side, at the right side, Tecnología. Okay. So this is what a header is. You have to click in the upper side. There. And now you see we are writing in the header. Left side, they want ES Infanta Elena. I double click on the right side there. And Tecnología. Okay. I can double click anywhere outside. And you see this header is going to appear in all the pages of the document. Okay. So next thing to do is apply a footer. Footer is the same thing as a header, but it is at the bottom of the document. So at the left side, we have to write first of SO, and at the right side, your name and family name. To the document, double click at the bottom of the any page, and we can type first of SO on the right side, nombre y apellido. We click outside and it's done. And we can see the footer in every page of the document. Next thing is to apply page numbering at the bottom of the page. So for that, it's very easy. And this is interesting to see what happens, because if you do this, go to insert, page number at the end of the page at the bottom, and we want it in the center. You see, now we have a number here, number one, number two for the second page, but the footer that we just created is gone. It's not here. So it was overridden by this page numbering. So the best way to do this now is to edit this footer. Again, don't erase the page number, but now we type again first officer here and nombre y apellido. All right, and that's it. We have the page numbers and the footer and the header on every page. And if the document was, the document had more pages, it would have the footer and the header and the page number on every page. So that's it. This is what you have to save, please, with your name on the file and attached to the task. See you later.